what's your thoughts about the afterlife?
I mean, if there is an afterlife,
if there is,
but I think that maybe it would just be kind of like just peaceful, like nothing, no like negative like feelings, no nothing bad, just nothing, just eternal peace. That's what I think, at least.
Okay, you believe in heaven and hell or something else?
I believe in something else. It's hard to explain, but like I do believe like there is like some afterlife,
yeah,
in some way. But I do believe there's something afterlife, of course, but it's just a matter of what it is exactly.
Do you ever heard of what Jesus said about the afterlife?
I have not.
So I'll give you what he said. Mm-hmm. And he says, I'm the way, the truth, and the life, and nobody gets to the Father unless they come through me. Mm-hmm. So either one of three things. Either he's lying, he's a lunatic to say something like that, or he's really Lord. He's a real historical figure. Mm-hmm. So let me just tell you what he said. I may appear like I'm a nice person, you know, and I try to be.
Yeah,
I'm nowhere close to the standard of what perfection or what God wants us to be. Mm-hmm. So the Bible talks about how all sin separates us from God. Man, I've lied, I've stolen, I've done things sexually that I shouldn't have done. Mm-hmm. Man, I deserve, on a scale, I think you're a great guy, mm-hmm. but on a scale, on God's scale, you deserve the same punishment that I deserve, based on what the Bible says. Mm-hmm. And this is what it's like. You got people in your family that you love, Justin?
Yeah, absolutely.
If somebody was to harm or murder one of somebody in your family, how much good can they do to pay you off?
I don't know. They have to do a whole lot for me to forgive them.
But you're not gonna, they're not going to pay you off to walk free, right?
Right.
They can't do enough to pay you off.
Right.
Well, our sin is what killed God's son, based on what the Bible says. So how much good on the day of judgment are you going to do to pay him off? You're not. It's just unattainable. Mm-hmm. So the Bible says we all deserve God's punishment and wrath. But the best thing that ever happened to me is God loved us enough to send his son 2,000 years ago. We broke the law. He sends his son to pay the fine. That's what happened on the cross, is that all of the sin of the world went on him. So let's just say you were in a courtroom charging speeding tickets. If someone comes in and pays your speeding tickets, now the judge can do that.
Just brush it off, like say, oh, they already paid for it.
He can let you go. Yeah. He can dismiss the case. But when the Bible says God sent his son, his sin, well, he was punished on our behalf, and he paid the fine in full. And just before he died, the last words Jesus said on the cross is, "It is finished." Meaning, all of the sin, all of your sin, my sin has been paid for. But unless you turn to him as your Lord and Savior, unless you return from your sin as best you know how, not by perfection, but direction, put your faith in Jesus like you trust in a parachute, when you do that, then the Bible says God will wipe the debt clean, and he starts that relationship with you, not a religion, and he loves you enough to do that. That's why he sent his son. And on the day of judgment, you won't be charged with hell because the son has paid your fine in full. Now, and the Bible even says that 3 days later, he resurrected, proving that Christianity is true. So if you would take what the son has done and accept him, you don't have to worry about facing eternal punishment for what you did against his son. The best news that I ever happened to me, my life changed, my mind changed, everything changed. So Justin, what you think, man? I know that's a lot of information. What you think?
I thought that was really good.
Really?
Yeah, I like it.
Really? Any specific thing that you heard me say that maybe stood out to you?
Probably just like, I mean, there was like a lot of information, but yeah, like I think everything stood out actually, like just the whole